Maria Magdalena. Oh oh oh, Alaydың арман еді. Oh oh oh, жүректің болған еді. Oh oh oh, өзіңсің жаным.
During my 6 months of internship in the city of Bishkek in Kyrgyzstan, I occasionally saw an amazing car drive around that I had never seen before. And that car was an Uaz Buhanka. Uaz Buhanka is a Russian car and it looks fucking sick. It's very, very strong and reliable, and it's definitely the best thing ever made by mankind. I fell in love with it, so I decided not to fly home to the Netherlands, but instead to buy a Uaz Buhanka and drive it home. Two of my friends, Daniel and Tom, were also in for some adventure and liked to join me. So together we embarked on this great adventure. To drive from Kyrgyzstan through Kazakhstan, over the Caspian Sea, to Europe, and eventually, if everything goes alright, we will arrive in the Netherlands. However, this idealized and simple plan did reveal nothing of the challenges we had yet to face. It will be an adventure in which we have to deal with the Kazakh police, face extreme colds, drive for weeks on uncomfortable roads, and have to live with each other non-stop in a barely 5 square meter van. But ultimately, it is an adventure that will give us priceless experiences. The first task was to find the Uaz Buhanka for sale in Bishkek. And we were lucky to meet up with Alex, who wanted to sell us his Buhanka. And look at this little green monster.
Hier is hij dan hoor.
De bus. De auto. Ook de zijkant. Nou, gaan nu weer verder. Later.
Alex even includes some 101 class in car mechanics. And that's something we really need, because all three of us did not have a clue about how the mechanics of a car actually work.
Fuel pump. It's the gaskets inside. It's new, and Genghis, he replaced the fuel pump. It's nothing wrong. Okay. With it.
It's very important when you just slam the doors shut. You know, when you close the doors, to slam them hard. So if you yank on this real hard, you'll break the wires inside.
What does the radiator do?
Cool. Cools the engine.
Cools the engine. So put like oil in it and it
pumps
it
around.
Cooling. No,
you only put radiator fluid in this.
Yeah.
Despite our lack of mechanical knowledge and the not so good state of the Buhanka, we decide to buy it anyway and go for the adventure. Let's hope that luck will be on our side.
Trip. Thank you.
Joel, find the white road.
It'll be good. Nice.
Next day, the first problem already arrived. We could not buy the Buhanka.
Of this documents, we need to have a contract, ownership, everything. Oh, not Tom.
Ah, duurt fucking lang.
Yes.
Try to transfer the ownership.
It didn't work out.
Alex's car to my car, or to me, but it didn't work out.
Yeah.
Because of bureaucracy. Personally, I don't actually why, because we don't have the third row of ownership, and that's why we can transfer the ownership paper but not the sell it. And we can sell it but not the ownership.
Yeah.
That's
why we get
problems.
Don't worry, it will.
It's going to be okay time.
Yeah,
okay,
good.
Let's hope.
But it turns out we are lucky. We were able to find our original car owner and to get the full ownership of the car. Time for step number 2. Preparations.
So, we better take some extra preparations.
We needed to get ourselves some spare parts at the local car bazaar in Bishkek.
Yeah, that's super van Melk bij zit. We zijn nu dus op de carbazaar om even wat onderdelen te vinden voor onze Uaz. Je kunt er alles vinden hier, allemaal ladders. Wat hebben we nog meer? Stoelen. Gordels, wielen, deuren, banden, motoronderdelen, carburaturen, alles. Alles.
Alles.
Alles kun je vinden hier.
Een trein.
Deuren, een trein.
At the bazaar, we met up with a friend of Alex, who you could recognize by his traditional Kyrgyz hat, an ak kalpak. He helped us on some necessities.
Хорошо, молодец.
Ракет, вот я задачу
буду.
Взял, брат, давай, удачи. Надо?
Да, надо.
We also did some shopping at the local supermarket. But we only bought the bare essentials.
Een mooie fles vodka en die kost 2 euro.
Dat is geen geld.
Ofzo.
Dat is geen geld. Tijn, wat ben jij aan het halen?
Cognac.
Before we embark on our great adventure, we decide to party. Because that's something we cannot do soon anymore. Next day, with an unbearable hangover, we were planning to leave for a big adventure. But before we could even leave, we had to be able to start a car. And that did not go without any effort.
It doesn't want to start. First try. Ah, managed. A little bit. Almost. What the fuck? First thing we try this car, the first moment. Oh. We're trying to start this car, it doesn't start. Ah, nee.
De benzine is
almost.
Ja,
het vast.
After a dozen of tries, we finally got it started. And we were ready to drive away into the unknown.
Traffic. In Bishkek. With hangover and anti-hangover cure. It's milk with gas. He's a bit relaxed now. Nice. And he has a hangover. And we are now exactly 2 meters further.
Here's the motor.
When the traffic jam ended, we could finally make some speed. And we noticed how intense it is to drive this beast. Changing lanes in downtown Bishkek is very difficult. And we already had a minor accident after the first 5 kilometers. Despite of this, we were fresh and full of excitement to finally start this adventure.
Het is gewoon een rechte weg dit. Bishkek. Geweldig, geweldig.
Wat een apparaat, joh. Wat een apparaat.
Hey, we zijn vertrokken.
Hier gaan we.
Nederland, Nederland.
Nu al, helemaal.
Holland. Zijn jullie bekend met blokken?
Zijn erbij, zijn erbij.
This excitement only lasted for a little while. Because just after 2 hours, after the beginning of our trip, we got stopped by the police.
Eerste aanraking komst met politie, nog in Kirgizië. Daniel en Tijmen zijn uit de auto. En die staan bij de politieauto. Ik weet niet wat er aan de hand is, maar we gaan erachter komen.
Nou, we rijden weer. Zoals jullie zien zijn Tijmen en Daniel weer veilig terug van de politie. En het bleek dat het busje, dat je daar een D-rijbewijs voor nodig hebt. Dus van een of andere bus en wij hebben een B-rijbewijs. Maar we hebben ze geld gegeven en die mogen toch doorrijden. En tip, als je gaat rijden, heb je nooit veel geld in je portemonnee.
Want als je het openmaakt en de politie kijkt mee in je portemonnee, dan zien ze 1000 zitten, bij 1000 kwijt.
Nou, dat is 12 euro.
Gaat om het principe.
Ja.
Nou, we zijn net voor de tweede keer aangehouden door de politie, Kazachstaans ditmaal. We waren aan het slingeren. En ja, die vent die wilde 1000 geld, maar dat hadden we niet. Dus we hebben hem 240 gegeven of zo.
So the vibe got a little bit depressive. And we became afraid that this will become a very, very expensive trip.
Optie 1 is scheid hebben en gaan. Met de kans dat we hele hoge bribes moeten betalen bij de politie in Kazachstan. En dat in Europa dat we gewoon echt officieel niet meer verder mogen rijden. Omdat we een fout rijbewijs hebben. En dus die banken niet in Nederland kunnen afleveren. En fucking veel geld verliezen. Andere optie is de hier rondrijden en dat ding weer terug te kopen. Maar Alex... Die heeft net verkocht en die gaat naar Caracol en het wordt misschien lastig om terug te verkopen. En de andere optie is om misschien via die categorie B en de categorie D in de categorie B te maken.
We were in doubt. Should we play it safe and cancel this adventure and drive back to Kyrgyzstan to sell the Buanka again? Or should we continue? Dat is ook
wel kut, want je moet ja, veel betalen ook. Kut! Kut.
Stay tuned.
We zijn nu bij de grens.
We hebben alleen maar video's gemaakt van dingen die misgingen.
Oké.
Deze thee gaat
niet weg. Dit gaat goed. Kijk, het gaat gewoon goed. Hier, kijk. Deze ook meteen omvalt.
Eventually, we decide to continue anyway. Even though this is the more stupid thing to do. But it is the more adventurous one. We cross the boundary of the known into the unknown. Insecure, unsafe and uncomfortable. But what we get for it is to be able to feel very, very much alive.
Dag 2, we hebben onszelf buitengesloten uit de bus. De uitsleutel ligt binnen.
Daarom firm.
En Oetke gaat nu proberen wat we hebben naar een prongraapje ook gedaan. En via daar kunnen we vast proberen om de deur van binnenuit open te doen.
Yes! Yes. Yes.
Nice. Mogelijkheden.
Next day we continued into Siam Ugam State National Park. And that was the moment when winter kicked in. The nights are getting colder and colder. And each morning we have to scrape the ice from the inside of our windows instead of the outside. Driving in the early mornings feels like your feet are frozen to the gas pedal and after a while our joints are not movable anymore. Luckily, after some time, the motor that's located in between the two front seats will warm us up.
Lekker! Driving in the snow.
Hij begint te merken dat het al iets kouder wordt hier.
Klein beetje.
Pissen, ja.
Maganda. Bili bili jingle.
had a lot of fun and good times when the Bahanka was working. But we also had many, many problems.
Garage. Mechanics.
En we rijden weer de garage in. Ja hoor, het is weer zover.
But after it was repaired and it drove again, we were even happier than when it wouldn't have broken down. Let's say a good adventure has high highs and deep lows. Without so many breakdowns, we could have just arrived home to the Netherlands, but instead of that, we get in contact with local people, have a lot of insecurities, have a lot of high highs and deep lows.
Daniel aan het snijden. Pannetjes erop. Een andere snijert. Ander pannetje.
The Bahanka is the ideal car to cook in and sleep in. We had to sit together in this van for weeks without any personal space. Surprisingly, we most of the times had good times.
For a nickel all the time. Fan life. You can't run away from it. Yeah.
Sometimes it was a challenge to park the car on a quiet place for a good night of sleep.
Lange trein, jongen.
Je ziet helemaal niks.
Misschien hoor je het wel.
Wel een rustig slaapplek in ieder geval.
Honderden wagons. Honderden.
Honderden wagons, maar het gaat maar door, hè.
The way home took us through gigantic empty Kazakhstan. They say the Netherlands is full. Kazakhstan is exactly the opposite. Nothingness everywhere. Kazakhstan mainly consists of steppe and it's very, very empty. Only snow, a few bushes and occasionally a camel. This peaceful emptiness will become our train for the next 1500 kilometers. This can become a huge problem if our car breaks down and there is no one around for miles.
Ja. Kamelen in de sneeuw.
Nou, deze beest geeft ook geen ene fok, weet je wel.
Moeten we niet even stoppen?
In order to save 700 kilometers of driving, we decide to take a bumpy shortcut of 300 kilometers long in the middle of nowhere. It turned out the road was more suitable for horses than for cars, and we had to drive it for the next 300 kilometers. It was not comfortable, but we did what the Bahanka is made for. However, in the middle of the steppe, there is no signal nor any people. So, if we get problems, it will be very, very difficult to get out. Let's hope our baby Bahanka will survive. At this moment, troubles were beginning.
Oh, oh, oh!
Acht, acht.
Bijna!
Negen.
Wat heen, hoor.
Tien.
Kom op!
Ja, nu gaat hij het doen, joh. Dertien. Choker, doe me even wachten.
Heb ik al gedaan.
Oké, ik stop mijn filmen, want anders is mijn film te lang.
Godverdomme!
For God's sake, the beast started. And we could continue on our bumpy road again.
It's for the next 170 kilometers. Let's hope the car survives. Yeah. Fucking middle of nowhere.
Like many Russian cars, its reliability is high, but the comfort level is around zero. And this we also noticed by the occasional scream from a local hitchhiker.
Ah!
At the end, we luckily made it without any problems. Yeah, Buanka, yeah! And suddenly we got a perfect new road. The border crossing from Poland to Germany is nothing compared to this one. Красный поезд Натали крутит счастьем. Весь зал заполнен, этот день мы все запомним. Бродяга, по жизни холостой, ему не надо. Жизнь в золотоях это свадьба.
Het draait super hard. Tijmen gaat even proberen de deur open te maken. Бродяга, по жизни холостой, ему не надо. Жизнь в золотоях это свадьба. Прощай, теперь покой сегодня стало.
Ты ему женой. Furthermore, we did do a lot of side trips. We drove around all day to visit amazing rock formations that were formed by the wind. We visited the Arrow Lake. But of course, there was nothing to see because the lake has dried up.
Hey.
Сила! Накружится, ведь мечты должны все сбиться.
We did some culture sniffing at the Asian city of Sauran, made by the army of Mongolian king Genghis Khan. Plus some mausoleums. At the end of Kazakhstan, the city of Aktau awaited us. From here, we will take the ferry over the Caspian Sea towards Azerbaijan. Unfortunately, in Aktau, we are getting problems. The Green Hulk lost all his forward power. We were stuck on a small but quite steep hill, and we couldn't get forward.
Beetje bij beetje komen we de berg op. Godverdomme.
The carburetor kind of exploded, and this was a sign to visit the mechanic again. The first three mechanics we visited did not know how to fix a car like this, and they advised us to visit the Buanka master, Lonya. And this big Russian mechanic could luckily fix our Buanka.
Плохо, да? Плохо.
Карбюратор надо разбирать.
For the rest, the only thing we had to do was to wait for the Caspian ferry. The ferry has an irregular and unknowable departure scheme. We have to call the ferry every day in order to check if it goes. And the answer has always been, no ferry today, maybe tomorrow. After a week of waiting, good news finally awaited us. No ferry today, but ferry tomorrow. Next morning, the Buanka was packed. The spirits were high, and we started our Buanka, but then it didn't start. Fuck!
Fuck.
After waiting for a week, on this crucial moment, the Buanka abandoned us. We tried every trick in the book, jumper cables, push start, cleaning the spark plugs, and more, but it didn't work. The car had to be registered before 6 o'clock, and we had only 2 hours left. We knew we were fucked, and the ferry we had waited for the whole week would leave without us.
Plocha. Plocha.
And even if we get the Buanka started, we run a great risk that it will break down again in Azerbaijan, and therefore we will waste a very expensive ferry ticket. The whole situation was nervous shattering, but eventually we realized that we couldn't stay negative, and we had to try a way to get in this ferry somehow. Some way.
Amen.
So we started with a prayer, and then we called the towing truck to take the Buanka to a final and last hope, and that was Master Lonya.
Daar gaan we hoor. Plocha.
Wat probleem.
Luckily, Destiny was on our side, and we were so happy that Lonja and his mechanics managed to get the Bohanka started. The only doubt we had was, should we turn the engine on?
Staan we dan, Tom, Timer en de bus. De bus draait, dat is goed nieuws. Maar gaan we hem uitzetten? Hierachter en Timer zijn op het industriegebied en Tom gaat jullie nu wat vertellen over wat we nu gaan doen.
Ja, ik denk dat ik weinig dagen in mijn leven heb gehad die zo fucking stressvol waren als vandaag. Of in ieder geval dat je niet weet wat er aan het einde van de dag gaat gebeuren. Maar het lot is ons gunstig gezind. Tot nu toe. We zijn hier gekomen met een auto die werkt na een hele dag dat hij niet wil starten. Eerst laten we hem nu draaien zodat hij niet uitgaat. Want als we hem uitzetten weten we niet of hij weer start. Dus nu moeten we alleen nog maar wachten op de boot. Dat is het enige. Dat is het enige. En nou ja.
Ik ben fucking blij.
Ja. Met andere woorden, we gaan hem aan laten staan.
Ik ben van voor van wel, ja. De boot gaat zo.
Wat vind jij?
Hoeveel benzine hebben we nog?
Heel veel.
Ja, fuck
vol.
Ja.
Hier, keuzes gemaakt, mensen. We gaan voor niet sustainable. Wageningen!
We decided to turn the engine off because the ferry took 70 hours.
Ah, sowieso naar Nederland.
Sowieso naar Nederland.
Giel, hier kijk het kamertje.
Kijk, mensen, hier is de haven van Azerbeidzjan.
We are very, very delighted to be able to start the car and to drive off the ferry into Azerbaijan.
Yeah.
It would, however, be nice to park the car somewhere close to a garage, because next day it refused to start again.
Problema, problema, problema.
Luckily, there were still some people around, and several Azerbaijanians helped us. On our way to meet our friend Marco and to party in Tbilisi.
Leuk. Op naar Tbilisi. Yeah, passen.
We gaan vanavond onze kop eraf gaan schroeven in Tbilisi. En het is nog ongeveer 500 kilometer rijden.
Wil je nog wat zeggen, Daniel?
Zeg yeah, van de koning houdt, zeg yeah, van de koning houdt, zeg yeah, van de koning houdt, zeg yeah.
En wat gaan we doen nu alles er weer uit is?
Kop eraf schroeven.
After a day of recovery, we drove further. But then we smelled antifreeze while driving uphill. And suddenly the Bohanka turned into a Turkish steam bed. Same afternoon, bam! One of our tires exploded.
Als jij het wil doen.
We had a spare tire, but there wasn't enough pressure in it, so we drove to some local people, and they had a tire pump to fix this. In exchange, we had to get a shot of cha-cha. Next day, we visited a beautiful carved out monastery and we drove into the beautiful Georgian mountains.
Maria Magdalena. Oh oh oh, talaydın arman edin. Oh oh oh, jürüktün bolğan emi. Oh oh oh, özümsin janım. Jetelip alğa meni. Oh oh oh, toratın jol bar edi. Oh oh oh, men üçin en ädemi. Oh oh oh, özümsin janım. Ay ay ay, chip chip chip. Chip chip chip. Maria Magdalena, oh oh oh, tamasha tanga deme, oh oh oh, ghashuk bo qalgan edim, oh oh oh, özine janam. Oğunshu sen de meni, oh oh oh, janıma en keregi, oh oh oh, suluk mängalemi, oh oh oh, özinsin janam. Ay ay ay, chip chip chip.
Life in the Buanca is very, very cozy. In order to sleep with the four of us in the back of the Buanca, we all have to lay straight on our backs. The starter broke, so we have to start every morning with a push start exercise.
Push-start poging nummer 5. Wow! Hij doet het. Hij doet het. Hij doet het, hondje. Hij doet het. Hij doet het. Ja, 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 ja.
The road carried us to Istanbul.
We laten Azië met per Uas Buhanka. En daar is Europa. Jullie kunnen het al zien liggen in de verte. Tering vet. Dat zwart is het water. Hier zie je nog aan deze kant Azië. En aan die kant, ja, dat is dan ons eigen continent.
Yeah!
Yeah! Mooiste continent.
Various web discussions warned us not to go into the city by car. But yeah, fuck that. Driving in the middle of Istanbul is crazy, even with a normal car. But with a Buhanca, it's insane. Tight situations, steep hills, and rush hour made it very challenging. Even though the small personal space, the vibe is still good.
Coffee.
The last border before the Netherlands, the Schengen zone. Against our expectations, was the easiest of all. Everything goes smooth, except for the mornings. It's always a surprise if we can start the car with a push start each morning.
En Tom Roijmans, die een 1600 kilogram zware Buhanca, Uas Buhanca uit Kyrgyzije gaan proberen aan te starten.
Dawai, dawai.
In er zijn even tijdens de uitzending weggevallen, maar een nieuw Nederlands record is gevestigd op de 300 meter auto duwen. Tijmen Schotten was door een blessure was hij geveld, werd gewisseld voor Daniel Davidsen en zijn brute kracht bracht de doorslag, waardoor de auto nu, je ziet hem in de verte al staan, weer draait. Jij voor Nederland en Jij voor de koning. Yeah! Surpassing! Yeah! Nou, dat de eerste poging.
Hij doet het! Poging 100!
De eerste poging was gedisqualificeerd. Want ze moesten weer terug bij de startlijn beginnen, zoals je kan zien. En we kregen hem na 5 centimeter weer aan. Want we staan nog op dezelfde plek als eerst. Yeah, koning!
Yeah!
Germany, our last test. Only 700 kilometers left. For the possibilities of getting caught by the police, a car breakdown or any accidents. The Buanca was slowly wearing down, which we concluded from a low speed and a smoke curtain behind us. On the German Autobahn, we got stopped by the police because we were causing a traffic jam. In advance, you have to know a few things. We don't have seats, nor seat belts in the back. The car is not very environmentally friendly, oil leaking and a smoke curtain behind us. And it doesn't meet the European standards of safety. And last but not least, it's a D-category car. We have been driving this whole trip without the appropriate driving license. The police had to admit that it was legal and eventually let us go. Last but not least, we passed the border back home into the Netherlands. P.S. In the Netherlands, the car broke down completely 20 kilometers before we could arrive in our hometown. But anyway, thank you, Buanca. Yeah, Buanca. Yeah. Hey, 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 hey.